Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to return to our Postgres Planner Quirks series to talk about how the Postgres Planner oftentimes misestimates JSONB selectivity. We'll start with this blog post by Eric Fritz on the Render blog. This is a blog from earlier this week where Eric talks about an issue that they ran into in their deployment pipeline. And they narrowed down the problem that they were seeing to this particular query here. The eData column is a JSONB column. And they're extracting a value here, service ID, and then they're comparing it against a different table. And so what they were seeing is that this query here, which was expected to be fast, took an extremely long time. And they were kind of puzzled why it was happening. I want to point out two things here. First of all, as they're noting, this query is bounded by limit one. The second aspect here is that they actually do have a multi-column B-tree index over an expression here. Now, just for context, there are two tables involved here. Their Postgres DBs table and their events table. Postgres DBs has about 100,000 rows. Events has about 90 million rows. The number of events that are related to the Postgres databases are quite small. It's just 0.01% of all events. And this is what they call the needle in a haystack problem. Only a small portion of the rows and events are actually necessary. Now, they run an explain, and in the explain, they first get what looks like potentially a reasonable result, which is they get two index scans. But you'll note that these index scans don't have any index conditions. So that means Postgres is using the index scan here only to return a sorted result, but then the actual filtering is happening in a merge condition. And so obviously this is quite expensive. Now the other thing to note here is that the service ID that this index is sorted on that the merge join prefers has a lot of entries to come ahead of the interest you're looking for. And so even if the merge join could terminate early because it was able to match the condition, because there's a lot of events that are unrelated, it has to do a lot of unnecessary work despite the limit. Now, the first thing that they put in place is they said, if we're getting too many unnecessary rows, can we just skip those? And so they added an explicit where condition saying, only look for the service ID that's prefixed with this Postgres service ID, which works in their particular situation. Now, this was actually much faster. But what's interesting is that the query plan was still a merge join. The only difference here is that we're seeing an index condition on the events table now. And so it was able to essentially reduce the amount of data returned from that index. Now, to switch to doing some testing without the limit, just to understand how Postgres would behave if you were fetching all of the matching data. And so what they ended up doing here was essentially refining this where condition first to only search for the prefixed events that are related to Postgres. And this ended up giving quite a reasonable performance here for the full search and then, of course, also for a limit. If you have more information about the problem domain, you can add additional where conditions to help Postgres find a better query plan. Now, Eric here said, we could have declared success here if they only had wanted to fix this slow query, they would be done. But they actually did dive deeper because they were saying, well, shouldn't Postgres have been smarter? Like, why did we need to add this where condition? And so this essentially comes back to PG stats and the information that Postgres collects and the planner statistics. And so if you have a JSONB column, in this case, the data column, Postgres does end up collecting samples from that column. And this also includes collecting most common values and histogram bounds for the JSONB column. However, because in their situation, they have a lot of events that are not related to the Postgres databases they're tracking, this essentially meant that despite there being most common values in the histograms, Postgres wasn't able to use this in its planning effectively. Now, what they ended up doing here, and this I think is essentially the most universal fix for this type of problem, is that they used extended statistics on expressions. You'll remember that last week we talked about a small security issue in that code that was recently fixed. This is a feature that was added in Postgres 14. And so here, for example, we can say, don't just collect statistics on the data column itself, do collect statistics on data service ID. And that way, Postgres now actually remembers more information about that particular aspect. So this information will now help Postgres get the good query plan without having to add that where condition. Now, you don't always have a quality comparison. So for example, in this 2020 blog post by Vsevolod Solovyov, he talks about pitfalls of JSONB indexes. And he has a slightly different query. So he's doing queries where he's saying JSONB field contains this particular value. Now, if you have a JIN index with a JSONB path ops operator, it's very common that you would use the contains operator to do a search in your table. That's actually a good pattern if you have unstructured data. However, what Vsevolod was seeing here is that when you had a lot of these comparisons, in this case, in an OR condition for something containing this publication or the other publication or the other publication, then at some point, Postgres incorrectly chose a sequential scan after a sufficient number of these OR conditions with the contains operator were placed in the query. And so here, for example, Postgres clearly misestimated. It thought it would get 7 million rows back, but it only got 200 rows back. Now, Vsevolod did some digging and found the const cell function, which has a fixed number of 0.1% for estimating the selectivity. So that means for a table of 43 million rows, it would estimate 43,000 rows to be the result of the contains operator. And then if you multiply that out and account for overlaps, Postgres ultimately comes up with the 7.8 million row estimate. Now, this used to be a very common issue in older Postgres versions. So for example, Adrien, Nayrat in 2017 wrote a JSONB in statistics blog post where he also talked about this exact problem. And he also ultimately ended up finding a const cell function. An important change in Postgres 13 is that Postgres did actually get a little bit smarter here. So back in 2020, Tom Lane started a mailing list thread on less silly selectivity estimates for JSONB matching operators, which ended up in this commit in Postgres 13, which improves selectivity estimations for certain assorted match style operators, specifically that contains operator, which, as Tom notes here, used const cell, and that was oftentimes not good. And there are two important changes here. First of all, the contains operator now does take into account most common values and histogram. So there are cases where if you have a high enough default statistics target, the operator will actually give you reasonable estimations now for JSONB columns. The other change here is that the selectivity was actually decreased because, as Tom noted here, 0.1% is actually kind of a silly estimate because these contains operators are oftentimes less selective than an equality comparison. However, this may also be counterintuitive. And so you might actually find that, for example, the issue that Vsevolod ran into, where he suddenly got a very high row estimate, that might actually be even worse on your Postgres version. And so I want to mention one last thing, which is what Adrien ended up doing in his blog post back in 2017, is that he changed from a contains operator to an equality operator. And so in summary, if you find yourself doing a lot of lookups on JSONB columns, and you're currently using the contains operator, try to instead do a lookup on a field like Eric is doing here with the service ID key, and then change that to an equality comparison. Make sure you have, in this case, a B-tree index on that expression data service ID, and then also create extended statistics on the expression so that the Postgres Query Planner has better information and can come up with a better plan. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 Minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.